Would you believe the secret to one of America's favorite candy bars, the Butterfinger, could be found at a Chinese vegetarian food festival in Thailand at a shopping mall right under the nose of a giant yellow peacock? Hi, this is Bernie Pepper, and I am cooking Thai food. For 9 days in the middle of October, all of Thailand celebrates Gin Jay, also known as the Vegetarian Festival. It was adopted by Thailand from its origin as a Chinese Taoist celebration of nine celestial gods. But Thailand, more than any other country, has brought worldwide attention to the festival, mostly through the shocking images of ritualistic body mutilation. It's a bit like Thai Halloween with real blood, especially in the city of Phuket, where it was first celebrated 170 years ago, and which still has the largest veg fest in the world. But for most Thais, it's the time of year that yellow flags pop up all over, signaling vegetarian food is available, from street food vendors, restaurants, and at food fairs like this one in Bangkok. A large portion of the entire population become vegetarians during Gin Jay, and also abstain from dairy, garlic, onions, chives, tobacco, coffee, insects, and insect products. And while sugar may not be healthy, it is vegetarian, and treats are also an important part of Gin Jay. Which brings us to this, the Dtup Dtap candy bar. Also originally from China, where it is still popular throughout the year, as it has been for hundreds of years. But in Thailand, the methodical hammering sounds of Dtup Dtap being made is the background music of this special time. Whole peanuts are combined in a billet of molten caramelized sugar. Then it's pounded over and over by two men with large sledgehammers, then folded, pounded, and repeated till the proper number of folded layers is achieved. Then, while still warm and pliable, it is stretched out and ground peanuts rolled inside. Finally, the roll is sliced into bite-sized pieces before it cools and becomes too brittle. See the folded layers of hard caramelized sugar and crushed peanuts? Folding the material over just a few times during the pounding results in hundreds of layers and creates a dense mixture of pulverized peanuts. This same technique has been used by swordsmiths in Japan for 1,000 years to create amazingly strong blades. The layers stop splits from propagating cleanly through the steel. In sugar, though, the layers separate and flake apart on each bite, making you look like a Butterfinger. Which brings us to this.
Crispity, crunchety, peanut-buttery Butterfinger.
Nobody better lay a finger on my Butterfinger.
Otto Shnering invented the Butterfinger in 1923 in Chicago. It was his second successful candy bar after the Baby Ruth bar. Look at the inside of the Butterfinger and you will find the same peanutty, layered, caramelized sugar as in the Dtup Dtap candy bar. I'm not saying Otto stole the idea from the Chinese, but consider that at the same time he was inventing the Butterfinger, Otto was tricking Babe Ruth out of millions by swearing he named the Baby Ruth bar after Ruth Cleveland, the daughter of President Grover Cleveland. She had died of diphtheria 17 years earlier. Is that really what Otto wanted people to think about when they bit into his candy bar? Diphtheria? And haunting memories of a dead little girl? Or the most famous American baseball hero of all time, who had just hit a record 54 home runs? And later, Otto stopped Babe Ruth from using his own name on his own candy bar because it was too similar to Baby Ruth. Anyway, I don't want to say many bad things about the man they call the US Candy Bar King, who brought so much enjoyment to so many for so long, I mean, the Chinese couldn't very well sue Thailand for stealing their entire festival, including the Dtup Dtap. Let's enjoy, but not forget the origins and lasting traditions that started it all, wherever they might come from.